And I'll call a meeting of the County Board of Selectmen to order on Tuesday, January 17th, 2017 at 6 p.m. Tonight we're being filmed by the Frontier Community Access Television. And the first item on the agenda is to approve the minutes of January 9th, 2017. I have a motion, a second.
I'd second it.
Any discussion?
And they look good to me.
Look good to me too. All's in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. And the minutes for January 13th, 2017. Make a motion, we approve that.
Second.
Any discussions?
They're fine too.
They're fine too. Great. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Nope, that carries also. Next item on the agenda is meetings attended by the Board of Selectmen. Do you have any, Bob?
So I went to two. I went to the Capital Improvement Committee meeting, and we talked about a couple projects that'll come up in the town meeting in the spring. And I went to the MCAP meeting. So that's the Anti-Pipeline Coalition meeting that Conway is a member of. And they're still just trying to decide, you know, how to reorganize for things that happen in the future. They're not doing, you know, any big projects.
Okay.
That was it.
That's it. All righty. And next item, I guess, is any citizens' concerns. Tom, do you know any?
No.
Okay, we have none of them.
Don't see any.
Pass over that.
We will have some more action on some nuisance dogs in the future, but we won't be ready for that for a week or two.
Okay, next item is old business for the appointment of Michael Kokoski as the highway laborer. Mike? Right, my name is Robert Baker.
Michael.
Nice to meet you. Bob Armstrong.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah. I guess you've gone through an interview with Ron and Tom?
Yes, I have.
And you passed your flying colors, I guess, so.
Yeah. I guess so.
You want to talk a little about your experience?
Yeah, I've been doing farming and construction, you know, since growing up. I was working in the union labor 596 out of Holyoke there for about 4.5 years, but just really hasn't worked out. So you know, that's why I applied for this position.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I've been doing construction, you know, farming my whole life. So you know.
Do you hold any licenses?
I just have a valid driver's license, and I am looking to get my oysters.
Okay. Good.
So.
Alrighty. Have any questions about
them? So you're talking about growing up in Hadley.
Yeah. Okay. Yep. Grew up in Hadley, and now I live in Florence. So.
Yeah. Yeah. Great. You know. Not too long a commute.
No, not at all.
Okay. Nobody else got any time? You got any questions for me?
No, I don't.
Okay. I'll make a motion that we appoint Mike Kokoski as the new highway laborer.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That's all there is.
Your only thing is your appointment will be approved as soon as you have a physical.
Yep.
Okay. Physical and a drug and alcohol test.
Yep.
Once I come back to town, and you're clear to go to work.
Perfect.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, we'll send you a letter.
Okay. Thank you.
Tom, we'll send you a letter. Make sure,
can you jot down on there with that pen your current mailing address?
Yep.
And if you have an email?
Okay.
I think we have that from you anyway, but if we can just be sure,
yep,
that'd be good.
Hey. Tom, we'll get that scheduled as soon as we can, I guess, right?
Yeah, we're on it.
Is that scheduling around or somebody?
We are on it.
Okay. Great. We look forward to having you working for us.
Thank you.
Somebody plowing the roads today.
Yeah, almost. I'm sure he's got his old crew up, probably, imagine.
Yeah.
All right.
All in the email, okay.
Yeah. You might as well put down phone number, too.
Yep.
You have a separate cell or just a...
No, I just that one cell phone number.
Thank you.
Great.
Thank you.
Yep.
Have a good night. Drive careful on your way home.
Yeah, thank you.
Could be a little slippery. Looks like the hill's all white out there, so.
Yeah, we'll see what happens.
We don't have as far to go as you, though.
Yeah. That's all right. Have a good day.
Am I all set?
You can stay or whatever you want to do.
Oh, thank you.
We're not kicking you out.
Appreciate it.
You out. Just take care on the way home.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Have a great night.
Bye. You too.
Okay, next item on the old business, the correcting the errors in the Deshevsky conservation restriction, which was previously approved, and we need to re-sign the applications and permits and stuff.
Yes, the errors were entirely in the town's favor.
We notarized for you.
Hi, excellent.
Here to notarize for
just
you.
In time.
All right.
She's here to notarize the signing.
Oh, good. We're
the,
just getting into it, Tammy. Good.
All right.
Yeah.
I'm just being careful because I have my ice creepers on and I don't want to fall.
Okay, yeah, don't do that. Do you want to give us a rundown of that, Tom?
Yes. There are only two errors in here, and both of them are in the town's favor. There's actually more acreage being saved for the housing envelope, out of the entire lot. There's a certain amount that's reserved for the house. Mm-hmm. It's called the housing envelope. They're actually saving more land around that, which will be taxable at a higher rate. So it's actually in a benefit for the town.
And you said there's another one too?
They both have to do with that. There's just two places that's mentioned in the thing here.
Bob, you got any other questions on that?
No, it seems very small.
Okay, I'll make a motion that we approve this conservation restriction of Mr. Deshevsky.
Second.
All those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Okay, I'll sign mine, sir.
Yeah, the second one was on Exhibit B. There was a more detailed description of the boundary.
Good.
Just like,
yeah. That's fine. Yeah, I think Tammy has
and
to
back. Back. Yep.
Notary public.
Great.
All right.
You pen?
Nope. Oh, got one myself. Okay,
thank you very much.
Traveling.
Traveling light, huh?
Travel with everything. And today is the 17th of January.
1717.
Yeah.
What's your middle initial, Bob?
G.
And?
A. Robert.
Robert
A.
also.
Armstrong, yep.
That's right.
Robert also.
Middle initial again?
A.
A. Please.
You might want to review this after the filling these other dates.
Yes.
Make sure it's all complete for yourself. Because I think there's three important places to get it. Alrighty, take care of that. Under new business now, we need to make an appointment for the 250th anniversary committee of Michael Lankarge, Michael Haley, and Kate French.
Were they going to be here?
Mike was going to try to make it, but I don't know. Do you know Mike? I don't know Mike quite well.
Mike Haley?
Mike.
No, Mike.
Okay, he's a real nice guy.
Nope.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised.
Have a good night.
Thanks, you too.
Because of the weather, but.
Yeah, I thought he was going to be able to make it in, but.
Other than that, I'd make a motion that we approve all three of the candidates.
Yeah, second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Approved. Okay.
Maybe we can have them come in another time.
Next one is the appointment for the representative to the Frontier Community Access Television. And the gentleman's name is Mike, is that Michael?
Another Michael Merritt.
Michael Merritt.
Yep.
And we received a communication from him today expressing appreciation for the candidacy but declining to accept.
Okay, so do we need to...
So that is tabled or...
And it's tabled and passed over. Need to be
we
looking for a new candidate?
We're going to find another rep, yeah.
Okay. All righty. Next item, reappointment of the Open Space Committee to Michelle Ture for a term ending June 30th, 2019.
Yes, we had apparently missed that back in June. Though it would be safe if we did this again. The records are a little unclear.
Okay. So Michelle's been in a lot.
She's very good.
We've all met her
a bunch of times. Yeah. I'll make a motion that we approve Michelle.
Or did you want to table that, Tom?
No.
Just
in case.
Yep.
Make a motion we approve Michelle.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. And there should be an appointment form for her.
Nope, there's nothing in here. Just this one. Just like I got it. I have my own.
Put it in the wrong place.
In the wrong place, honey.
Hold on.
That's easy to do.
Let's see. Let me fix it.
And now we're going to do the 250th committee first.
Yeah.
Yeah, where it says, I think it says chair.
Yeah.
If you could just put clerk, scratch it out and put clerk, and then that's you.
Signatures, I guess, right?
Just one, that's fine.
Just one is all it's got on it, right?
Yeah, now? Yeah. It's just because you did take the votes, it's okay.
That's Michael Hatch. This one's Michael Haley. Michelle Ture for the Open Space Committee.
Great.
Okay. Next item on the new business is open the warrant for fiscal year 2018 annual town meeting on May 8th, 2017. You got some on that?
Yeah. Well, if you vote to open the warrant, then anybody who wants to, I will publicize it. Anybody who wants to come in and talk about having something on the warrant. This is the season.
Yeah.
It opens the season.
Great. Open season?
Open season on the select board.
All right. Yeah. I'll make a motion. We open the fiscal year 2018 annual town meeting warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Okay.
And I do have, you have the draft warrant there.
Yeah.
Draft warrant, yep.
And so far, you can see Article 2 is still pretty incomplete.
Yeah.
So that's, those...
We're closed in on some of them, huh?
Those numbers are still coming in. But I did put it in just to show you how it looks with
the new order.
I did check with Nick Filler, and it's fine with him to do it this way.
Boy, that's going to be a lot... clear for people in there.
Yeah. I think it will. So that's that.
That's really nice. I like that number.
Then as we're going down, right now these are pretty much all placeholders.
Okay.
But I included, you know, spaces for them. There's usually $125,000 for capital stabilization. Yeah. I'm going to, as I always do, suggest $100,000 for the Highway Garage Stabilization Account. The Conway Grammar School has requested $50,000 for their stabilization account, and in Article 6, they have also asked for $35,000 out of that account to spend on a number of capital items. I've sent that to the Capital Improvements Planning Committee.
Hmm. You know how much they have in their account now, huh?
They have a lot. They have a lot more than this. They've got over $100,000. So they've got plenty for the request that they're putting in now. Then I have a placeholder for $20,000 for the General Stabilization Fund. For the hydraulic boom lift, we'll get a report back from the Capital Improvement Planning Committee, but that's what was talked about. The Conway Grammar School Library also, I had a request for $4,000 for an air conditioner for that. I'm going to check to see if that's part of their capital expenses.
Is that
expenses.
Capital? Yeah.
I got that request a long time ago, and so it's been waiting by itself for a long time. I'll just see if it's included in the other one.
Right here.
They talked me down to $3,000 for hard pack for the back parking lot here.
Yeah, yeah.
Instead of paving. I'm sorry?
What was your previous figure?
$10,000 for paving. Uh-huh. Now, it would have been less than that. Because that was an estimate for the whole lot, and we wouldn't have been able to do the whole lot because of the septic system that's out there. And that was actually a little over $8,000 to request, but it was a year old. So anyway, that's
that hard pack is pretty hard once you get it rolled in place and rubber rolled and stuff.
My only concern is what happens in the winter, because it's pretty uneven out there. I consider it a safety hazard, trip hazard, and it's certainly not a great thing if people want to come into the back of the town hall.
Ron felt he could do a good job. Worth having him with it. He's got this material now.
Yeah.
So. But it is over and above what he was planning to do, so special purchase for that. The assessors are requesting $2,500 for the conversion of their computer system that they use to communicate with the state. They have to change it one way or the other. This is the version that the state is supporting and actually providing some money for. So if we go with their system, we spend this much. If we try to do something on our own,
they don't have
a
computer line item in their regular budget, huh?
This is a special, one-time special item. So after this, we'll fold it into the regular IT budget. And we could put it in the regular IT budget too, if that made more sense to you. Article 12, they had requested some time ago to repurpose some amount of the money that we had for re-roofing the central office to use for relocating into Frontier. So
they've already got the 29, right? And they're just need to relabel it.
I will check in to see that's still the right numbers that they're talking about, and
that's been quite a while ago, huh?
Yeah.
In the fall, actually.
They may be counting on it and waiting for us to pass it. So long as they have the money by the end of the fiscal year, it's fine for
I
the books.
I think they've already done the work.
Right. But that doesn't mean that they don't need the money.
Right, oh yeah, the balance of your accounts, yeah.
Yes, exactly. We always have something for a transfer for the ambulance stabilization fund. We also have something for operating expenses for the ambulance department. So those two items are in there, but we don't have figures for them yet. The assessors are now asking only $5,000 because now, and I'm going to have to check on, it was triennial, but I think the whole point of bringing it down to $5,000 is it is now a five-year revaluation of property. So I will check with the assessors on that. We'll get some money that we have to spend on the library. So that's a usual one. this looks worse than it is. The town clerk bill from a previous fiscal year is about $90.
Okay.
So instead of it being four figures, it's more like two. And the ambulance department bill for the previous fiscal years is about $300 or $400, so that's also not a very large one. There's just a blank for 19.
Is that ambulance bill, is that something that could be absorbed into this year's budget if it was approved?
No, it's from a previous year, so it has to.
Because I know that she got a fair amount of money set aside for them things. Now.
Yeah. And it takes a 9/10 vote.
Mm-hmm.
So, but it's a small item.
Yeah.
Article 19 is just a blank.
Okay.
Article 20, we'll get figures for community preservation.
Yeah.
I had the idea, we have money left over in for improving the town ball field, and we've got about, well, we have $7,788.98, and I think that it would be worth it if we have to. I'll check with Joyce to see whether we would actually have to, but I think if we don't get any action from our town council is looking at the contract we have with Weston and Sampson.
Mm-hmm.
You know, to litigate something like that might end up costing a good chunk of what we would actually get for.
Was that over the sand issue or the material?
No, that was for the
tennis,
the
court.
Tennis and basketball court not being pitched properly.
Mm-hmm.
It has
mm-hmm.
some dimples in it that collect water, and mm-hmm. it's mm-hmm. not going to be good over time. But. You know, repurposing that money for making improvements. We may or may not have to, because it was improvements to the ball field, but again, I'll check with Joyce to see if that's within the scope or not. We'll see if we have a request for the wastewater engineering study. I know the wastewater committee is continuing to meet with the one engineer that was interested in doing the project, and they have some concerns. They did visit, which was nice, and they are going to submit a proposal.
Okay.
So I don't think that we're going to be on the timetable that they had originally hoped for, which would be to have a special town meeting to vote on the engineering, which would be done in time to vote for something at town meeting, if the town voted for the engineering funds. So
this is for the engineering funds.
That's what I have in here now, just because I don't see the timeline working out at this point.
Okay.
It always could. And then there's just there's another blank. There's a space for the right to farm bylaw, which I didn't put in, but there is a revised version on the web now, if anyone wants to look at it there. There are some revisions from the previous version. Relatively modest changes, but they might make a difference to some people. And then the rest are different kinds of articles we might have, but we don't have them yet. I also don't have the correct slate from Ginny as to who's going to get elected in the election, which is the way Conway does it, of course, an extension of town meeting.
Yeah.
So that's what it's looking like now. A lot of blanks, but I thought I would.
It's coming together.
You know, it's the beginning of the process.
Yep, it's open.
Very good. Thank you.
Oh, yes, I actually have copies of that right to farm.
Oh, good. Really?
The new
you.
Draft for you now.
Okay, next item is items not anticipated 48 hours in advance of the meeting. Do you have any time?
I do not.
Okay, we'll pass over that then. Town administrator update.
A few items here. This is to you, and let's go that your way. Good catch. For committees and boards, the assessors are proposing that the town accept a settlement Verizon negotiated with the state regarding an overvaluation of their property.
These poles? That were
no, this was work done along the line by the river, I think. Hmm. There's something going up there, some cables. And the state set has rules for how to value them. Verizon's, and then they're implemented by the towns. Well, Verizon sued, the state settled, and now the towns have to, are given the option of agreeing to that settlement or not.
So it's just $3,000.
Since it's $3,000.
We have to come up with $3,100.
And they can, that can come from the existing overlay account, which is good. So it's pretty much an accounting change as far as we're concerned, and we're out of the woods as far as that goes. For
but
departments.
2% of that would be $60. Right? This is
yeah.
I mean, that's the amount the tax would go down by this revaluation change. Is that right? Or is this the amount the taxes are going to go down that we get from Verizon?
No. We pay them this
much. We've
got
to pay them back that much. We've overcharged them that much.
Right. Okay.
So this is just paying a settlement that's
just
been
a level thing.
I see. Okay.
Yeah. Chances are we'd have to pay a lot more if we try to negotiate a town to Verizon agreement. For departments, the highway department and I, in this fine weather we're having, would like to remind residents that the sand and salt mix is available at the town salt shed. There is a special pile for residents. So far, residents have taken about 100 tons of the mix in pickup truck loads.
Well, I don't know if it's pickup truck loads.
Well, some of them have been. So there's a lot that goes out. People do use that. We'd also like to remind residents that salt, just the salt, is off limits. They may not take straight, residents may not take straight salt, which is much more expensive than the sand salt mix.
So the sand salt mix is the pile that's back and to the right of the salt shed?
Saw the door facing Route 116.
Okay, well, I'll look in there.
It's far left hand way over.
Okay.
And that mix is about 1/10 salt to keep the sand from caking. For towns considering a marijuana moratorium vote, Kopelman and Page, the law firm, are recommending the timing of fall 2017.
So do we still have to do this?
We don't have to do anything. This could be either a zoning article at a special town meeting, requires a 2/3 majority, or a ballot vote. It could also be a general bylaw. I don't think they mentioned that here. After a year's time by which the initial retailers would be in place, the town could further move to prohibit the sale if it wished to do so. So there are lots of options out there, but the best recommendation is to wait until fall 2017 before doing anything, because it won't be until then that there's a process in place for retailers to start.
Copeland and Page, they represent the whole county, do they, or on this issue?
No, they represent a large number of towns, over 100 towns, cities and towns. And they frequently give workshops. This was a workshop at the Franklin Regional Council of Governments.
And so at that time, they'll have a recommendation of what to do.
Oh, well, you know, it is up to the town. I mean, some towns might want to encourage the sale. Other towns will want to prohibit the sale. So they give the variety of options. You know, this is how to do it if you want to do this. This is how to do it if you want to do that. And I have some of those materials from that workshop if you'd like to see them. Our emergency management director has asked George Murphy of 84 Lucart Road to become his assistant director, with the intention of his taking over the EMD position when Dave Chichester leaves town at the end of June. When I get his contact information from Dave, I will have him come in to meet the board and get appointed. And I have, since I wrote this, I actually got his email address, and he will be planning to come on Monday.
Good.
We have received two more recent complaints against the dogs at 651 Graves Road.
Were these the same ones we had before?
Yes.
Same dogs?
Yes. Yeah. I am working with the animal control officer to set up a nuisance dog hearing. It is not going to be as early as Monday.
Okay.
He feels that we need to give a lot of time, a lot of advance notice to all parties in order to have people be able to attend, which is a little bit too bad because we will be starting up more frequent joint meetings with the Finance Committee for several weeks. I hope to try to get it in before then, but it looks...
Is the dog hearing at a select board meeting?
It would be best to do that, I think. We are all set to switch phones. Town phones from Crocker to Network Advantage. The changeover is scheduled for Friday, January 27th. That's a week from this Friday. With follow-up work over the weekend and on Monday, January 30th. Well, that is my update.
Tom, going back to this animal control officer meeting, hearing, is that something that we should have the police chief attend?
I do believe he is one of the interested parties.
Be a good idea, I think.
Yes, absolutely.
Great. Thank you, Tom. Okay, any concerns on the select board?
Nope.
Okay, hearing no concerns, we'll move over that. Mail, we have no mail, I guess, that I can see here. Any announcements?
The only piece of mail that I saw was something about the Hampshire County Selectmen's Association. And I did leave that on top of the thing over there, but I think you probably got that in your own emails anyway.
It may have come today, and I don't see it yet.
We'll make sure you get that.
We're being invited to a...
The Hampshire County Selectmen's Association always invites.
They do, that's what I hear. It's the invitation, yeah.
Okay, no other announcements. Our next meeting is scheduled for Monday, January 23rd at 6 p.m. here in the town office.
And I will just note that on the 23rd, we should meet again at 7 o'clock, because we scheduled about a month or a month and a half ago, we scheduled a meeting for the Community Development Block Grant hearing,
okay.
And that was scheduled for 7:05.
Do you want to change this to 7 p.m. then?
Yeah. If we have next week, it's just during this changeover to an earlier time, we had some prior commitments that we should. So unless you want to stick around for an hour.
No, it's fine.
And do that.
To make sure we tell John.
Okay. If we have no other business in front of the board, I make a motion to adjourn.
I'd second it.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay, this meeting is adjourned.